Operation IceBridge is one of NASA's new missions, and what we're doing is we're monitoring the sea ice and the ice sheets. Right now we're up in the Arctic. We also go to the Antarctic. We're using the NASA aircraft to monitor these areas because our ICESat satellite recently died, and ICESat 2 will not be launched until 2015. So in the interim, we're using these aircraft. It gives us actually improved capabilities over the satellites, because the satellites were measuring the surface elevations of both the ice sheets and the sea ice, and with these aircraft we can add additional instruments that peer beneath the ice.
New findings about the health of the Arctic are about to be released. Can you give us a preview of how the ice fared this winter?
Yes, actually we're flying over the sea ice right now because the sea ice is coming out of the winter season, and in the winter it grows, in the summer it shrinks. And so right now, coming out of the winter, it's reaching its maximum extent. What we're seeing from the satellites, we have a 30-year history of this, that the sea ice extent is about average this year, just a little below average. So that's good news that it's about average, but it is thinner than average.
Well, why is the Arctic ice such an important measure for Earth's climate health?
The Arctic ice is a very important measure for the Earth's health because the Arctic will see climate change first, as well as it'll see accelerated warming. The Arctic sea ice acts as a mirror on top of the Earth, and as it shrinks in the summer, it does not reflect back the sunlight. It can warm the oceans. As well as when we look at the ice sheets, as we see warming there, we see speed up of the glaciers, the outlet glaciers, as well as thinning, which relates directly to sea level rise. So these are important areas to monitor.
IceBridge isn't just looking at sea ice, but at glaciers too. Why are they so important to study?
Yes, we're actually looking at the glaciers on the edges of the Greenland ice sheet right now. These are called outlet glaciers. These glaciers drain the ice from the interior of the ice sheet and flow to the ocean. What we've seen in these glaciers over the past two decades is that many of them are thinning, as well as increasing in speed, and that means they're taking more ice and putting it into the ocean. So we really want to understand the dynamics of what's going on with these glaciers so we can make better predictions of sea level rise in the future.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the aircraft that NASA's using? What kind of instruments are on them, and what are they there to do?
Yes, NASA's using two different aircraft. We're using our DC-8 aircraft as well as our P-3 aircraft. These aircraft are outfitted with many different instruments. We're using two different LIDAR measurements. These LIDARs are a laser altimeter, and they send a laser pulse down and they measure the surface height of the ice. Then we use radars. We use four different radars that all look at different depths into the ice. Our deepest radar will actually look down to the bottoms of the ice sheets. It can look through 3 kilometers of ice and monitor what's going on at the bases of the ice sheets.
Well, where can we go to learn more about Operation IceBridge and Earth's poles?
You can go to our website, www.nasa.gov/icebridge. There we have live Twitter feeds as well as blogs, so you can see what's happening in the field every day, as well as get more information.